and gentlemen, welcome back to the World CX Summit. And right now we're on CX technologies are becoming mainstream. Well, the technology is empowering customers to create very personalized experiences. The CX landscape is rapidly changing. To stay relevant, companies are deploying emerging technologies like the virtual, augmented reality, intelligent voice assistants, chatbots, other forms of AI and IoT connected devices. These emerging technologies are widely used for CX in production today. For our topic on emerging tech panel discussion, the impact of emerging technologies on CX, where we're looking at covering how to maximize CX success with new technologies, what are the challenges in deploying CX technologies, how CX technologies is paving the way for revenue digitization, which CX technologies reduce overall customer effort, how will AI transform customer engagement, what are the CX benefits driven by intelligent voice investments, does VR, AR have the potential to supplement brick and mortar CX, and how to unlock the treasure trove of IoT data? Well, ladies and gentlemen, for this, we have got our eminent panelist, Suneet Gupta, Head of Customer Experience Growers. Well, Suneet, being the customer experience, heading the customer experience, leading the organization in its voice of customer program and customer experience strategy. In addition, he's also heading the Grofer Market, which extends the Grofer's value proposition to own offline customers, especially in the Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities. Thank you so much, Suneet, for joining us. Well, we also have Himanshu Singh, Head Pre-Sales India and South Freshworks. Well, Himanshu has 15 plus years of experience and has worked previously in companies such as SAP, SAP and Adobe. He has helped thousands of companies over these years with their digital transformation journey and transition to the cloud. Thank you so much, Himanshu, for joining us and giving us your valuable time as well. We also have Dhruba Roy Chaudhary, Head of Global Command Center and APAC Support Operations, Community Operations, Uber. Dhruba has close to 14 years of experience working as a senior operations expert with a track record of spearheading cross-functional teams to manage large-scale global outsourcing centers and in-house operations for multi-million dollar organizations. Thank you so much, Dhruba, for your time as well. We also have Anand Thuli, Head of Data Analytics and Customer Experience, Vedantu. Anand, a business leader with leadership and entrepreneurial experience in managing product development, data analytics, and customer experience across diverse sectors of e-commerce, retail, and management consulting. Thank you, Anand, for joining us and giving us your time. We also have Guru Bhatt, the VP Omnichannel and Customer Success Platform, PayPal. A technology leader, Guru, with 20 years of experience. He's somebody who's been instrumental in driving PayPal's technology strategy in India as the company builds out next generation payment solutions and services. Thank you so much, Guru, for your valuable time. And this entire conversation, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be moderated by Ninath Raji, the Director and CIO, Health Assure. Well, Ninath is a visionary information technology, healthcare, insurance, and financial services senior leadership professional with in-depth and 26 years of experience in successfully spearheading large global organization. Thank you so much, Ninath, for agreeing to be the moderator of this wonderful session. As you can see on your stage and screen, are our eminent panelists. So with this, Ninad, the ball's in your court. Please take it ahead, over to you.
Thank you, Bhavana, for the great introduction as always. And I welcome this eminent panel for today's discussion and conversation. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and a very, very warm welcome to all of you. It has an absolute pleasure to be a part of the World CX Show, which in my opinion is quite a unique concept, which brings together the best that customer experience has to offer. As you are aware, AI, IoT, AR, VR, robotics, data analytics are quite pertinent nowadays in the technology circles. Add to that, the entire bonhomie around customer experience. We keep hearing about traditional brick and mortar, CX, modern digital experience, human personas in customer experience, intuitive customer interactions, CX via gaming, et cetera, et cetera. But are these just buzzwords, or is there any real merit associated with it? Does technology really pave the way for better customer experience? These are quite pertinent questions, and I'm sure all of you are quite eager to know and understand the basis of this. And what better way than hearing from those who are quite well entrenched and richly experienced in these concepts. Together with us today is an elite panel of experts who have years and years of hands-on experience in customer experience technologies. On behalf of the World CX Show, I welcome them to this panel. Without further ado, let's discuss and gain insights and also some wisdom from these eminent personalities. Let's begin with Guru. Guru, we all are aware that in today's day and age, technology is the primary driver for business. However, it will be great if you can let us know, how does one maximize CX success with modern technology? Over to you, Guru.
You are on mute.
Well, that's the obligatory sentence that one has to hear these days, at least once in the meeting. So I'm glad to have provided everybody with that opportunity of hearing it from me. Sorry, folks, for being on mute. So Ninad, great question. And as you rightly said, we are in an age where technology is pervasive across all aspects of our life, and especially in business. And you know, if I were to paint a picture for you, maybe taking my own company, PayPal, as an example of why technology is inevitable, consider the scale at which we operate. We have about 375 million and growing customers around the world. We operate in over 200 countries. On in the year that passed us by, we transacted close to $1 trillion on our platforms throughout the year in terms of total payment volume. On any given day, we have in excess of 35 million transactions. So this is at that scale, for you to be able to control the customer experience in any way that doesn't involve technology is simply not possible. Technology is inherent in everything that we do. And in when it comes to customer experience, what is the primary goal of a company like ours? It is to be there for the customer when they need us the most. In our case, it happens to be in digital payments. In other businesses, it could be other equally powerful missions and visions that power them. But in all these cases, when you couple a very meaningful and impactful vision and a mission with the scale at which we need to operate, then technology is the only way that you can guarantee that the customer has the kind of experience that would showcase our company's value around customer obsession. And why is customer experience needed? Why should we obsess around it? It's because end of the day, any business, in order to fulfill its mission, needs to earn the trust of its customers. And if you don't have the trust, there is no way you can even survive as a business, let alone stay true to your mission and your values. So in this case, what happens with customer experience, when it comes to building trust, what are certain experiences when you have the most opportunity to win a customer's trust? When things go wrong. So for example, in our case, let's say a transaction gets declined, or if there is a hold or a limitation that is placed on a customer's account, if you have on average about 100 million customers reaching out, there is no way you can handle this in a manual fashion. You have to rely on technology. You have to rely on the sheer volume of data that we are able to gather on our customers in order to deliver them the kind of experience that instills trust. So when they face an issue, when they reach out to you, if you're able to treat them with the kind of empathy that allows them to feel like they're well looked after, well taken care of, and their problem gets solved, and they know why the problem occurred in the first place, then it's very likely that they look at your brand as a trusted brand, a valuable brand, as a brand that really is looking out for them. And they are more likely to be loyal to your brand as a result of that. And so in this journey, technology is, you know, not just a key enabler. I think it's an inevitable part of the journey for any customer. So for us at PayPal, when you're looking at 100 million contacts a year, people reaching out to us for a variety of different issues. Ideally, we would love to have a human being interact with every single one of them, but that is simply not possible at the scale at which we operate. So the best help in some way is self-help. The ability for us to proactively look at the data that we have, infuse AI and ML into all of our experiences, be able to predict proactively the issue before the customer can even detect that there's an issue, give them a solution even before they have found that there was an issue. Or in the worst case, when they do reach out to us, have enough context and content that is pre-generated that allows us to truly engage with them in a way that tells them that we not only understand the issue, we also know how to solve it. That's the utopian North Star that we are all aiming for in terms of customer experience. And in this, the thanks to the volumes of data, just to give you a sense, right, we have over 500 petabytes of data that we gather on our systems as people transact. We never share this information with anybody. It is super secure. That's the sacrosanct responsibility for us. But we do use it internally for our purposes to be able to give better customer experiences. With 500 petabytes of information, for those of your listeners who are interested, that's like taking 4,000 high-res digital pictures every single day of your life for the rest of your life. Even then, you will not hit 500 petabytes, right? That the only way to harness the power of that is through AI and ML and deep learning. And we use this to our advantage in order to solve customer issues when they reach out to us.
All right. Thank you, Guru. What an excellent thought, Guru, that rather than customer experience, it is all about customer obsession and winning the trust of the customers. And to your point, 500 petabytes of data, that's some mind-boggling analysis and data points for you to kind of churn. So, and this can also only come from your wild experience as well. So thank you so much, Guru, for your thoughts. We will circle back to you in a short while. I just want to make sure that I go back to the other panelists as well. And let's shift focus to Sumeet. Sumeet, just wanted to kind of understand, and I'm sure audience would also like to understand from you, during your several years of professional journey, you've implemented various technologies, I'm sure about it, probably hundreds of them. If you can just elucidate the challenges you face in deploying CX technologies, I'm sure the audience will also sort of want to know, because the audience, I'm sure a lot of people here have been sort of involved and engaged in implementing various technologies. So I think your insights and experience would also help, especially revolving around the challenges.
Okay, thanks, Rana. What you have asked is quite a journey. What we have gone through at Crowfirst, I would say is where we actually focus towards the savings and providing the maximum savings to the customer. There are quite a few challenges what we have taken up from technological perspective, moving from balancing between the how you provide the digitized communication or bots or the manual communication or in at what channel the customers prefer to communicate with. But rather, I would focus mainly on the intelligent systems. Guru has covered a few things, the main intelligence comes in the customer experience if you actually see it in three parts, where what we have to analyze is what happened, what could have happened, and what should we do? Considering the data points of millions of customers collected in one single database and identifying these journeys providing the right package for the single customer is the intelligence what we are solving. That is what the key is. Customers ask or assume that the systems know they are actually asking, which is a readily available information which customer have provided or customers had looked for, right? Which should be readily available to them. And speed is where human interaction may not be able to compete with the tech, right? So collecting all the data points, realizing the overall consumer journey, including their purchase history, their previous interactions, their browsing history, and all the millions of data points, connecting all the dots, pulling the right strings, and providing the information in the simple and concise way is where what we actually want to provide the right experience to the customers. And that is where actually customers expect, means where there is a mix of readily available information and plus the human touch involved, where we have to provide people what need to be done and what should be done in a certain case, where the human, as a human who is interacting with the customer, is not involved in taking decisions means they have to look for multiple data. It need to be readily available based on the experience which a customer has already gone through. And that is the intelligence what we thrive for. And it doesn't come in a single day. It means the systems train themselves. We build, that's why I said it's a journey, because from the first day itself, you start with something, some dots, and you start populating and start making it intelligent and intelligent. The problem is actually till perpetuity. Means every day, every hour, the system is becoming intelligent. The system is creating certain experience in that. And that is where I would say our tech team has actually gained a lot, handling with that data, mapping the overall journey to provide the right package of what need to be done or what information need to be readily available for the customer is the key aspect which we have solved, and we keep solving that.
Great, Sumit. Excellent. Very interesting thoughts, Sumit. You spoke about intelligent systems. You spoke about the packaging and providing the correct packages to the customer. Very, very interesting, because that's very pertinent. And also providing info in a very simple and concise manner to the customer. That matters a lot, actually. Otherwise, customers would think probably this is not their cup of tea and they move on to something else. So very, very insightful. Thanks, Sumit. We'll also come back to you a later point in time. Let's sort of shift focus to Dhruba. Dhruba, in today's day and age, what I believe in is generating revenue has become the quintessential element for any business. And I'm sure everybody agrees with me on this. If you can share with us as to how CX technology is paving the way for revenue digitization, because revenue is mainstream as of now for any businesses. So we'd like to hear your thoughts as well.
No, absolutely, right. To give a bit of context, right, as you know that Uber has promised to the streets that we'll be EBITDA positive by Q4 end of this year. And obviously our promise was last year, but obviously kind of, you know, COVID derailed us. And as we speak, you know, our main three business, mobility, which is our largest business, which got largely impacted by COVID, it's already a profitable business. And we are on our path to kind of make our delivery business profitable as well, and therefore hitting our targets. So obviously, I think, you know, TLDR revenue, of course, makes sense, right? And that too, you know, from an aspect of a portion of that revenue needs to kind of, you know, move towards our profitability as well. Now, there are, you know, largely 3-4 things that we use from a technology standpoint to kind of drive revenue, right? One is, you know, for both our products, like large-based products, which is mobility and delivery. Mobility meaning ride hailing, delivery meaning food, right? And my role is kind of, you know, to lead this product from a CX standpoint, APAC-wise. So we still have our each products in multiple countries within APAC. So I'll kind of touch both. Now, one thing that we have observed is, you know, we did multiple psychoanalysis and we come to a conclusion that, you know, the sooner you would be able to catch what customer wants the moment they are on our app, the fall rate reduces significantly. Meaning, you know, the moment, you know, your offering matches what they're looking for, they would ideally click and kind of, you know, submit their request versus going to a competitor app. Now, how to do that is, you know, basis what kind of, you know, Guru touched. We are kind of, you know, fortunate to have, you know, humongous amount of data through which we, you know, decipher more or less our customer need. Meaning that, hey, if, you know, he or she is looking for a ride at a particular time, basis the past requirement, we understand whether the person would prefer a auto or a moto or a, you know, four-wheeler cab, right? for countries where we have eats, you know, kind of tracking at what time he or she is kind of looking into our menu. We know that generally this is the time when the person has, you know, coffee and donut, and we will kind of, you know, put that up the value chain so that, you know, we immediately meet his brain signals of what he was looking for and psychologically drive him to order from our platform versus really searching in other platforms. So that's one way, right? The second way, you know, that we do is there are two sides. There is a supply side, there is a demand side. Now, from a supply side standpoint, and I'm glad that Guru is here, you know, we observed that barring US, UK, in most of the countries we operate, you know, in close to 90 countries, there were many countries which were cash driven, right? Mostly. Now, we in last 5 to 7 years have taken, you know, a very patient and painful journey in changing our customer spending habit by moving to digital channels. So globally, we are partnering with PayPal. In India, we have partnered with Amazon Pay. We of course believe in kind of, you know, not reinventing the wheel when we have, you know, great product in the form of, you know, PayPal and Amazon available. So we partner with them, right? And what we do is we have now really put those options, you know, as a paying option for our consumer, meaning our rider limiter. Now, how does it kind of affect us? You know, there are times when we have seen in the past that, hey, a customer wanted to order but doesn't have the right currency denomination at home, or didn't have the cash and hence dropped the idea, thinking that, hey, if I go out to take out cash, I'll kind of, you know, buy from the shop itself, right? Now, providing, you know, like removing that friction channel digitally also have enabled us in upticking our orders. Now, the third piece to this puzzle is supply, meaning really our delivery partners and couriers, right? And our drivers who basically, you know, drive in our platform or deliver food in our platform. Now, one of the key thing that we noticed that initially they had, you know, this fundamental concept of we will go with cash, meaning, hey, like we need more cash trips, specifically in most of the countries, barring, let's say, US, UK, or in Australia, New Zealand. Now, we also, again, took pain, like, you know, it was a very patient journey for us to kind of train them in understanding that, look, if you accept digitally, the advantage is that in cash payment, every 7 days you have to come and submit your earning and get your portion from Uber. So obviously it's a physical hassle. And B, if you don't do that in every seventh day, then on the eighth day, you get blocked. Like you will not get a new order or a new trip until you submit that. And we said that if you accept payment digitally, then you get your portion of earning at end of that day. So there is no hassle, you have the money. And because now by doing this, they also kind of, you know, sign up with PayPal, Amazons and Google Pay of the world, they inherently become a part of this digital pay life cycle. And that helps us because, you know, they get more habituated in making them accept digital payments because they also spend digitally and hence accept their income digitally as well. So I think largely these are the three ways in which we have really moved our revenue throttle from a digitization standpoint, because once we have these things digitally, to one piece which I think Sunit and Guru both touched, right? I mean, your defect reduction also increases significantly, meaning we can track very easily, hey, if you know there is a expected
sure, sure, Dhruva,
defect,
I think
and then we make the payment.
Yeah, so that's
kind of what we do.
Yeah, that's excellent thoughts, Dhruva. Thank you so much. What I noticed is about psychoanalysis. That's a very first in the industry. How do you actually understand and get into the psyche of the customers and the consumers to drive your business? Very insightful. Thanks, Dhruva. Let's shift focus to Anand. We have Anand here as well. Anand, as we know, nowadays, all businesses are striving hard to reduce customer efforts, you know, and make everything very easy for them. Simplicity is absolutely required nowadays, right? According to you, which CX technologies reduce overall customer effort? And if you can also let us know why, that would be really nice. If you can just keep it short because we are running short of time. Thank you so much, Anand.
Sure. Thanks, Inad. So one thing which is very unique with EdTech, especially the kind of offerings which we have, Ninad, here, is that we have one business transaction and we have a long service cycle over which the value transaction happens. right? So the learning, so you buy the course right now and then you study with us for the whole year, right? Now, that particular engagement, right, or that particular promise from the customer, there exactly he's, you know, he's committing a lot of time and effort. Learning any which way is a very effortful, you know, kind of a paradigm, right? So the whole idea behind, you know, the CX, especially the service part, right, of the customer is kind is primarily based on, you know, reducing the effort, right? Now, I'm not sure how much you guys know about it, but there are like four primary parts to the effort. Cognitive, that is, you have to think, you know, how much are you thinking? I'm not talking about the real learning part. I'm just talking about, you know, the interacting with the systems, processes, and brand per se, right? Then you have an emotional part wherein something goes wrong or something goes up, right? Something really, you know, kind of excites you. So that's the emotional part. Physical part is, of course, you're physically going anywhere. And that's what primarily we are doing by bringing tech to ed, right? And ed tech is primarily in terms of that you don't have to move around and, you know, the value transaction. And then the time part, of course, where students are anyways committing, right? So the primary way, right, Nina, we are trying to, you know, reduce the customer effort is trying to work on the cognitive part by making the systems much smarter, right? By bringing in AI, bringing in much more personalized engines so that different students coming from different backgrounds, you know, we can reduce their, you know, collective cognitive effort, what they would need to, you know, put in to interact with the systems, right? Now, learning as such, you know, it seems easy, right? It's all about, you know, coming onto the video and, you know, start learning on the video, right? Especially when you have, you know, a wave kind of a platform. But in our case, the student also has doubts, right? They also give test assignments, right? There's a whole schedule behind, you know, behind that value transaction, right? The idea is to make that particular, the whole journey as effortless as possible by personalizing their journey, identifying those needs proactively rather than, you know, they coming up with that. And that's one of the primary ways we go about reduce the customer effort, right? The second part is, as I said, right, bringing in more artificial intelligence in terms of understanding the customer needs and also delivering it on the platform, right? That has primarily been the way, right? And then, of course, there are chatbots, there are proactive messaging, there's whole brand messaging system which works here so as to ensure that, you know, that emotional and, you know, time needs, you know, anything which, you know, drives students away from learning, that can be reduced. So that's primarily the way, you know, or those are the technologies which we are using. I'm hurrying, Nina.
Great, Anand. Thank you so much. I understand, and thanks for being within the time. You touched based on great topics: cognitive thinking, emotional elements, emotional parts, and of course, we all know e-learning is nowadays in vogue everywhere. You know, everybody is looking for e-learning courses and so on and so forth. So we'll also circle back to you, Anand. Let's move focus to our friend Himanshu here. Himanshu, as we know, Freshworks is the market leader in customer engagement and always launches extremely innovative products. We all know about it. We also know that AI is the next big thing. Everybody keeps talking about AI. In your opinion, how will AI transform customer engagement? If you can just throw some light on that. Let's keep it very short as well.
Sure. So I think you all understand the requirement of AI, right? Why do we need it? Obviously, to scale and reduce the cost. Big 24/7 availability, process data models. But I think there are five key ways that AI is already transforming customer experience. I think Dhruva spoke about avoiding, which is proactive service, right? Second is deflect, which is self-service. And here, you know, technologies like bots or self-services implemented by AI. Third is routing, which is the most important thing that, you know, for example, Freshworks is doing, right, which is building data models on correctly routing the issue to the right team, right? And this is really hard to build for companies. Results in faster service for when you report an issue. The next is assist, which is personalized assistance to people, right? Not have a generalized way of interacting with the customer, but giving them a little more personal experience related to their challenges and problem, and this sets context to the person resolving it, or the AI understands the issue in detail and then acts on it. The fifth metric is obviously reporting, right? So which is very important. AI can use multiple predictions and technologies to really give you analysis about details of what kind of customer issues are cropping up, why is it cropping up, what can we do to resolve it. These are the five ways that AI is already transforming customer experience, right? And this is obviously helping in obviously processing large amount of data, suggesting the right solutions to customers, as Dhruva touched upon. Proactive outreach, I think we've also spoken about, where I've seen even customers building IoT technologies to detect any problems and then automatically creating cases and deploying solutions to resolve those. Obviously, personalized interactions, this helps in customer retention and automating a lot of long tasks. So these are the ways that AI is transforming. I know we are short on time, but happy to discuss it more with anybody who wants to touch base on this.
Sure, Himanshu, thanks. Thank you so much. I think it's insightful as well. I'm sure others would want to, the audience would want to kind of reach out to you. I'm sure you will give them the contacts so that people can start using your products, very innovative products. Just for information, I personally, my organization also uses Freshworks for our entire contact center. So that's first-hand experience. As promised, Guru, we are circling back to you, and I'll request all of you all to kind of keep it very short because of shortage of time. Guru, I'm sure, you are richly experienced in omni-channels. You're heading omni-channels in the highly competitive payments industry, PayPal and all. In your experience, what are the CX benefits driven by intelligent voice instruments or other investments?
So there's a couple of different categories, Ninad. One is around conversational AI, where we are making significant investments to infuse more conversational elements to our user experience. And the reason is, when people reach out to a company with any issue that they may be having, typically they like to talk to a human being on the other side, especially when it's an emotive issue like money. The reason is because they feel the empathy from a human being. And for lack of a better term, your interactions with chatbots and such are robotic, right? They are currently the way most of them operate. But with the right kind of voice recognition, tone recognition, mood recognition, etc., built on top of AI and ML, you're not only able to infuse the right amount of empathy into the conversation, even with a bot, but you're also able to do entity extraction correctly. Because when we're talking about something, I might call in and say, hey, my credit card is not working, and as a result, my transaction failed. There are multiple things there. There's a credit card, there's a transaction, there is failure. There are various elements that a bot has to pick up. And with conversational AI, the understanding of human elements of language becomes that much better. And so we are able to turn that around and make it that much of a richer and more empathetic conversation. Secondly, when it comes to bot, things like Alexa, Siri, Google, it's a very simple way for you to ask simple questions, right? You can say, send money to Ninad, and Ninad will get the money right away without me having to pick up my phone and do all of this. Or what's the balance on my account? One of the most common use cases for people to call us is to check on their balance. 11 million calls, in fact. Now, if we could just transfer that to a voice assistant that could do it, that would be tremendous operational savings for us. So the opportunities are endless, and we're just scratching the surface right now.
Great, great, Guru. I think one pertinent point that you had mentioned, very insightful, conversational AI and bots are the way forward. I think what you have done for your organization and for the industry is great. So thank you so much, Guru. We'll again circle back to Sumit. Sumit, you come from the online retail sector, Grofers and all. It will be great if you can share some insights into your journey of deploying latest technologies within the online retail industry. Do you think the advent of AR and VR has any potential to replace traditional brick and mortar CX?
Interesting question. So means AR, VR is actually means making a long way and means it has created a good impact in a lot of industries where we are actually catering to one part of customer experience, which is perception. Perception and feeling, if we define it. So perception, they are actually catering to in a really, really modified way. I would rather not call it as a replacement, but it is definitely creating an added experience and enhanced experience towards that. They have to live together. Means they cannot replace totally the human feeling out of it. Means when we talk about Guru has also touched base on that where we have. Where he has mentioned about the conversational or AI and everything. Means there is a feeling involved, human feeling involved when means customer with 0.5% of the chances as well, if the customer is facing an issue, they want a human intervention, they want a listener, they want certain empathy to dealt with, right? So that need to be catered to, and we need to be empathetic and catering to that situation as well. So currently it is actually an added advantage. Having said that, means as we all know, artificial intelligence has also becoming less artificial by with time as well, right? So means with the better technologies and everything, means we are actually circling back to more of tech involved in this. So yeah, means why not in future, means they will have the added portion in the consumer experience.
Great. Sumit, empathy towards the customer. I think that is something which you have mentioned and which also helps in a great customer sort of experience, satisfaction, obsession, all these sort of elements. Empathy is absolutely required. And that also comes with training and rich and diverse experience. I'm sure about it. Let's move on to Dhruba. Dhruba, you come from, of course, the transport aggregation space, taxi hailing sort of industry, where you have already implemented several path-breaking CX technologies that we are all aware of. And we, of course, all of us use Uber for our daily needs and requirements. So we are sure this also creates like gazillion amount of IoT data for you captured via millions of mobility devices, right, all across. How does one unlock the true potential of this data?
Yeah, so first and foremost, Sinad, I want to kind of give assurance to everybody in this call, plus everybody who is listening, that your data is safe with us. We do not share it with anyone, obviously, and we follow the highest GDPR standards. Now, coming to how we use it, I have touched it briefly in my last question. So, you know, we mostly use to derive your user pattern and to help you gauge your decision making at a much faster rate whenever you are accessing our platform for a need, be it while hailing, you know, a transportation need, or be it while ordering food, right? So that's primarily how we use it. On the support side, whenever you face a challenge and you reach out to our support team, obviously we use it to anticipate the challenge or the problem that you have faced, and we try to kind of solve it without you facing minimal or no friction at all. So that's kind of how we use the data that we have today, and ensuring that it is protected and not get kind of shared or spilled over under any circumstances.
All right, Dhruba, thanks for touching base on this and mentioning that our data, the consumer's data, is all safe and secure at your end. It does not get sort of shared with anybody. That gives confidence to all, the entire world, in fact. And thanks, Dhruba, for sharing that. Anand, just wanted to kind of shift the focus to you. And you come from the edutech e-learning sector, you know, which is in this pandemic era has really triggered several virtual education platforms. I'm sure about it. Everybody knows about it. Can you share with us the importance of data analytics in CX and how does it really help? It would be great if you can recite a few examples, because I mean, you head the entire data analytics platform for your organization, Vedantu. We'd like to understand from you.
Thanks, Sinad. This is my favorite topic. I can speak like for 2 hours, right? But in the interest of the time, see, just to you know, let's tell you in a nutshell, right? CX, the way I see it is, customer has certain expectations. CX is just the measure of how do you meet those expectations, right? Now, if we go by that, there are three parts to CX management, if I can call it that, right? First one is gathering, right? That is, you know, knowing what your customer needs. Second one is analyzing or designing what your customer needs, right? And third one is actually acting upon and delivering on that particular experience, right? Now, in edutech, especially in our case, there are two primary aspects or two primary vectors of customer engagement or customer experience, right? One is learning engagement, maza aya, and second one is learning outcome, samajh aya, right? And these are cyclic, right? The way we use data analytics, and I'm fortunate enough to head both the divisions at Vedanta, right? The way we go about it is for learning engagement and learning outcome, all three aspects of customer experience, right? The gathering part, the analysis and design part, and action part is what we try to drive through data analytics, right? For example, in gathering part, coming up with those scorecards, coming up with those discoveries, the insights in terms of which points out towards or, you know, which reveals what do customer need, right? The analysis and design part is pretty much, you know, kind of figuring out in terms of what would we do to go ahead and, you know, deliver on those expectations, right? Now, there's a pre-class to it, there's in-class engagement, and there's a post-class engagement aspects to it. For example, how many tests to be given, right? How many quizzes to be done during a particular class, right? If a class is hard, how to pace out a particular class or session or a course, right? Or that is where the design comes in. The actionable part is, you know, as you guys would know, right? It's all in the personalization engine, you know, sales optimization engine, scorecarding, right? So everywhere where we, you know, kind of deliver on that, right? In terms of a certain kind of mapping to the expectation, right? A differentiated mapping with two different student bases. That's where data analytics comes into it. And similar case in learning outcomes. So that's how I put it.
All right, Anand, thank you so much. Analysis pertinent to scorecards and other elements. Well said. I think it gives us a lot of insights as well. Let's move on to Himanshu from Freshworks. Himanshu, so I have been talking to many leaders across the industry, especially dealing with the CX sector in various industries as well. And what comes across is that none of the CX platform service providers have everything under one roof. And that's common knowledge for all of us. Moreover, neither of them are best at everything. In this context, can you share some insights as to how does one decide the CX strategy and the best CX platform provider? Probably how can Freshworks help business in this context?
I think in terms of CX, I'll restrict myself to customer service, right? So if you talk about customer service, customers are expecting four major experiences, right? So the first one is a voice experience. Second is messaging experience, fourth social experience, and the fourth one is digital experience. So these are the four, right? So voice, messaging, social, and digital. I'll give you an example of the largest fintech company in India, right? So using some things, something we're taking the world's largest solution, using a social media platform for social ticket creation, using one of the on-prem phone telephony systems for nothing, right? No automation, no AI, and the fourth one is they were building their own bots, right? So disconnected systems, disparate systems. If my transaction failed on their platform, then a user will go to social media, tweet about it, send a email, raise a ticket from the app, right? And there will be four different agents working on this, right? So this is the problem with the experience today, that there are disparate systems not joined together, right? And AI ML is separate. There's no one common AIML which you can put on voice, which you can put on bot, which can put on data modeling for ticket generation or for ticket routing. And most of the players don't have tight social media integration in the same platform, right? So you've got to go with something which starts with an S or an O to get those tickets, and then you have to integrate, right? So that's the problem right now. When we started planning for building a CX platform, customer experience, we started with the thought process of combining all these things, right? And there's one AI, central AI, which caters to all these requirements. There's a centralized platform which brings in content from each source and combines the data all together. So obviously, we embed AI for deflecting and avoiding and all those things. But if an agent comes to view the ticket, he will know these are the sources. This is the combined social media platform. This is what he called on voice for. This is the resolution. And AI will also give a suggested solution for that, right? So So I think this is the requirement now to really combine these data sources, combine AI to form a single platform and give the user a seamless experience, right? And other thing is obviously, I think like Guru was talking about omnichannel experience. So that's also lacking right now, that you have to go to different sources to provide omnichannel experience. Customers nowadays expect that the platform should be where I am, right? So millennials prefer WhatsApp, maybe some other generation prefers call, right? And really depends on business to business, but you should enable your customers to be able to reach out to you from wherever they are, whether it'll be Facebook or it's Instagram or it's Twitter, right? Or it's your app or any other tool that we use. So that's the key takeaway. The tool should be where the customer wants and should have integrated single AI platform, single data source to address these queries.
Great, Himanshu. Thanks for sharing insights. And I'm sure your innovative products are going to be very, very useful for many businesses across the globe. I think you also touched based on a very important sort of aspect wherein millennials, they prefer digital sort of technologies nowadays. And I think that's the way forward for all of us here. I think there's great learning for us and as well as the audience. So absolutely brilliant. That was quite a power-packed discussion on the hottest topic within the customer experience circles. I'm sure all of you would have gained important insights into strategies, planning, and what do we need to be really mindful about whilst embarking on our respective customer experience journeys. With that, I guess we have some time for taking questions. I'm sure our panel of experts will be happy to address any questions that the audience may have. I'm opening the forum as of now for any questions. Probably we have time for one question. I'll sort of look forward to the organizing committee here if there are any questions.
You know, Ninad, one thing about when you moderate is you moderate it so wonderfully that you actually encapsulate the entire topic. So the audience questions honestly haven't right now been coming for this particular panel because you must have addressed everything regards to the topic. But Ninad, since we do, I mean, of course, we are a little bit stretching on the time, but that's because you guys had such a great conversation. Ninad, I'd love your panelists to probably give the last few minutes to a closing from their end as well.
Sure, absolutely. And before that, I would like to thank our panelists for sharing their valuable experiences and providing us deep insights around the groundbreaking CX technologies. I, along with the expert panelists, would also like to thank all of you for joining this session and making it an inclusive and interactive session. Finally, a big thank you to the PressCon team and organizing and inviting us to the World CX Show. Or the panelists, if you have any thoughts.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, over to you. Thank you, Bhavna. No, thanks for the opportunity. I really had a wonderful time. Thanks to all the other panelists as well. It's great getting to know a little about them as well as the businesses and the customers they serve. I think technology is here to stay, here to grow. As tempted as we all may be to assume that things are moving too fast, a sobering thought for us to remember is it will never be this slow either. It's only going to get faster. So I look forward to all the great things that the world has to offer us in the years ahead and have a wonderful year in front of us.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Guru. Himanshu, your final thoughts. We've got just...
Thank you. Yeah, thank you for inviting me. I think one thing that I'm really excited about is the digital experience that all of us are working on, AI-powered digital experience. I think that's the future of customer experience. So that'll be my key takeaway from this discussion. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you. Dhruva, your final takeaway?
First of all, thank you, TSCon, for inviting. Thank you, everyone. It was a learning experience. The one thing that I tell to team, and I'll kind of tell here to everyone as well, as users, your experience is what you imagine it to be, right? So be fiercest critics of our product. And do let us know what you need more from our product, because that enables us to kind of deliver that to you. Keep using Uber. Thanks.
Perfect. Thank you, Dhruva.
Sunit,
over to you.
Yeah, so it's a very wonderful topic. And since considering that technology is evolving day in, day out, and being customer experience, which actually drives the growth, is, and it requires a lot of efforts, and technology is the key in converting that customer experience to the growth of the company as well. So I guess he's looking forward for the emerging technologies inside customer experience.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Sunit. Anand, last word to you.
Yeah, so thanks, Rescon, and thanks. It was a lovely discussion. I've been on some balanced discussions. Believe me, this was one of the best ones which I have been to, right? Going back to the topic, CX is the right way to do the business, right? Everybody understands this. And as far as I believe, right, technology is the only way to bring scale, speed, and quality to the customer experience, right? There is no other way, right? So both CX and technology is going to stay, right? The idea is it really depends on us. How do we use it to give best to our customers, right? So that's how I think.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Anand. Ninad, with your kind permission, it is now time to close this wonderful panel. Thank you, Ninad, firstly, for moderating it. Any final thoughts, Ninad, from your side as well?
Yeah, thank you so much. Would like to really thank the Trescon team for organizing and inviting us to the World CX Show. I think, Bhavana, you've always been a great anchor. And thank you so much to our fellow panelists as well. I think great discussion. And I'm very sure that our esteemed audience here, they have received a lot of insights and they can move ahead in their own strategies, in their own journeys, whilst they implement their own CX technologies and moving forward. So thank you so much. Have a nice day ahead.
Perfect. Thank you, Guru. Thank you, Ninad, for that. Thank you, Guru, Anand, Dhruva, Sunit, Himanshu. What a great discussion. World CX Summit, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Trescon Global, a big, big thank you.